Hey guys, this is an installation video for Blade and Souls. As you can see over here, Blade and Souls is being developed for the West in the US. However, you know, for the past year or so, the game has not been released for the West. Now, if you can't wait for NCSoft to release the English version of Blade and Soul, you can follow this guide to install Blade and Soul from China, and we can get it translated to English. Now first, before you do anything, you need to get a QQ account. So follow this link, get your QQ account, particularly the QQ account number, okay? And then get to this page, which is the official Blade and Soul China. Okay, this is the game client download. And you can see over here there are quite a number of selections that you can use. The first four, they are all actually free, and these two are more or less paid services. Now I'm going to bring your attention to this third one, which is over here. It says added speed, so just go ahead and click this. Okay, and save the download. The next thing that we're going to do is to download the game platform. And what this does is, like any game launcher, such as the VNet, the BattleNet launcher, as well as to speed boost, okay, the game. Well, because we are all playing outside of China, you will definitely experience some lag. What this game platform does is to make it a little bit better. You will still get some lags here and there, but it's gonna be playable using this. So go ahead and download this and save the download. Now, while the game is being downloaded, I want to bring attention to Windows 8.1 users. Now, you must go to your control panel and go to region over at administrative, and change your system locale to Chinese Simplified China. Now don't worry, you know, about your applications your application names and all the text being becoming in Chinese. It's only for games, okay, for non-Unicode programs and games. Alright, so just go ahead and do that. You'll be prompt to do a restart or a logout and log in again. So just do that. Okay, so I have the game client and the game platform being downloaded, so go ahead and run this. Okay, which is the game client itself. Okay, so what happens is this. This is the game client downloader. We should have downloaded the installation files necessary to set up the game. Now, what this means is to log in. So, I'm sure you already have your QQ account, so just go ahead and type in your QQ account number and your password. Alright? And click on this button. Now, what this button does is to quickly download the setup files. Okay, so I've already done this. It took me about 4 hours. So, once this is done, click on this button again and you will run the setup file. Now you may be wondering where the files are being downloaded. It's actually to the specific drive that you have, and the folder name will be named as game download. Now this is the actual one that we are running right now. Now, right after the game has been installed, they will ask you to install this Microsoft Visual C++ 2005. Now, if you have this already installed, you don't have to do it again, so I'm just going to click no. The same thing for DirectX. If you don't have it, just accept the agreement and go ahead and install it. If you already have it, just cancel. Alright, so the game client has been installed. Okay, so we're going to install the next thing we're going to install is the game platform launcher. So double click on this. Don't worry if it's taking a long while, because it's supposed to be like this. I do not understand why myself. Just be patient, it will be up. Yeah. Now let's go ahead and do this. I'm going to install this at E5. Right, there you have it. So finish. Okay, enter your QQ number. Okay. Right, this there. Now if you can see this, because we already installed the game client, so what does TGB, the game platform launcher, as well as the booster does, is to scan the game, and it did successfully after installation. So you'll most likely see this button over here, which means to update the game. Alright, apparently the download on the server is not the latest patch, so yeah, we still have the patches. This button over here and this button over here are the same, so just go ahead and click this, and TGP will download the latest patch for you. Okay, so while the patch is being downloaded, I'm sure you will realize that there's something going on after installing the game client, and you will see this. Now, in my opinion, this is what we call a blockware, so something that would eat your memory. Definitely would not do something that you will understand, but basically what it does is to, you know, clean up redundant files in your system, speed up your computer, something like utilities. So I'm just gonna uninstall this. Alright, so make sure you close that completely. It looks like this icon over here. Just do a right click and quit. This means yes, it is still there. Apparently there's something still scanning, so I'm just going to quit. Alright, so basically we are done. So now, how do we uninstall this? The best way to do this is to navigate to the directory itself. So if you install it in C drive, it's actually under program files followed by tencent QQ PC manager. That's the one, the blockware, and followed by the folder, the version number. Alright, you will see this uninstall.exe. If it's a run and yes, it's asking you for reasons why you want to uninstall. Just click other reasons and blah blah blah. Okay, this means cancel, but this means to uninstall immediately. Alright, so three options here. Okay, remove all redundant files, folders and everything. Click finish. Alright, you see there are still some temporary files. My recommendation, do a restart, come back to the directory, and delete the entire Tencent folder. Alright guys, so basically the patch has been done, so let's just go ahead and launch the game first. Okay, basically here it says you need to apply the patch. So this button says confirm, so this is confirm. Okay, let's go. Alright, seems that the installation is successful. Right, you can see over here, they are all in Chinese. So I'm just gonna quit the game and apply the Chinese patch. Alright. So this is the page. Okay, basically this guy has been updating, translating all the English, all the Chinese words into English. So give this link a download. Click save. Alright. Now it doesn't matter where you install it, it doesn't have to be in the game folder. So I'm just going to install it in my B drive. Okay guys, so right after the English patch application has been installed, you will see three icons, shortcuts over here. So this is the TGP game platform launcher, as well as the speed booster. This is the game itself, and the Chinese English patch is the one that we just did the installation. Now before you do the English patch, you need to launch the game client first. This is the portal. You can ignore all these details because basically we just need the game to be active. Now go ahead and run the English Chinese patch. Alright, simply just click apply patch and you will start the download. Now do take note of this. Every time when Blade and Soul gets an update, you need to run this China localization patch. Alright. Well, it doesn't hurt to run every day before you start the game, but if you do encounter problems or when you see the game launch in Chinese, give this a run. Okay. Okay, let's test this. So when you launch TGP, which is this one over here, you will get this. Now if you realize over here, they are all now in English. The settings. Now do take note that some parts of the settings are still in Chinese. Okay, but I'll do this explanation on what they are in the next video. Basically, most of the important stuff, they are all translated in English. Alright, enjoy!